Green zone! Green zone! Green zone! Green zone! Green zone! Green zone!
Hello and welcome to episode 2 of The Grass is Greener with the Dartmouth Track and Field and Cross Country staff. Today, our moderator and our special guest is Tim Brennan, a graduate of Dartmouth, a 2017 graduate of Dartmouth. He majored in government. And actually, Tim was a thrower on the team, a two-time captain. And he was number four all time in the weight throw at Dartmouth, as well as an academic All-American in his career here. We were super excited to catch up with Tim. He's a couple of years out, but he's doing some fun things. He's currently a senior analyst at Optum on their new project development team. And something really interesting, he recently founded his own track and field recruiting startup. It's the Torch College recruiting app. So he's doing a couple of things. We're excited for him to be on the call with us. And Tim, thanks for coming on.
Coach Dobson, thanks for the introduction. And thanks for having me on the Zoomcast. One thing you'll hear from almost every Dartmouth student and alum is that the Dartmouth community and the people at Dartmouth are really special. And the traditions at Dartmouth is something that helps build that common bond, a common experience that all students share and they carry with them after they graduate as well. So I'm having a quick conversation today with the coaches about what are their favorite experiences or their favorite traditions at Dartmouth. And I was hoping to start with Coach Jaworski. You've been at Dartmouth for 7 years now. What are some of your favorite traditions at Dartmouth?
Yeah, I am actually kind of biased being primarily a cross-country coach, or at least my past here at Dartmouth, but our cross-country men and women's trip to the second college grant is definitely my favorite tradition. So a little background, Dartmouth is the most landowning school in the country. We have a lot in our portfolio, including Mount Moosawak, which I'm sure we'll touch about if someone talks about trips, I don't know. We have our own skiway, which is great, our organic farm, and it's really cool. But part of that is the second college grant, which is 27,000 acres in northern New Hampshire. And every year, our men's and women's cross-country teams go up there, and we have about a week of fun. I always say it's forced family fun because there's no cell phone service and you're kind of like fending for yourself a little bit, but there's a lot of cabins up there. I think there's maybe 10 or 11. The men usually have two cabins, the women have two cabins, the coaches have a cabin, and we do a lot of team building up there, a lot of great running on the logging roads and the trails. We oftentimes see moose, which is pretty cool. And there's a little half moon beach over at one of the cabins, and there's a lot of hanging out and just kind of having fun. So goal setting for the coming season ahead is done up there. And again, just kind of hang out with your best friends. Our team is really, really close, and to have that time up there is pretty great. So it's a cool aspect of Dartmouth, just all that land we have, and we definitely put it to use throughout the year. So the second college grant trip is unique and definitely top on my list.
Yeah, I don't think there's a more Dartmouth introduction to Dartmouth College than going to the grant. And yeah, I didn't have the experience of going there as a non-cross-country athlete, but I've always heard good things about it. And one of the great things about freshmen too is you get to go to both the grant and do your freshman first year trip as well. So you don't miss out on either of those two experiences. And I know, yeah, I've just heard all the cross-country kids rave about it when I was there. Now switching to Coach Farino, do you have any traditions in particular that you like the most?
Yeah, the first year trips, as you mentioned, and Coach Jaworski mentioned, are very unique to Dartmouth. It's a great way for our students, our freshman students, to come in and get to know others. It creates socialization, make contacts, lifelong friends, from what I hear, and it gives you a level of comfort before you start school. And it also helps our student athletes to learn about and appreciate the outdoors, which is great. Some of the things that they do are, hiking. There's different levels of hiking, mountain biking, kayaking, and all different sorts of things. I know they go up to the farm, and some people do organic farming. So there's something for everybody. And I've heard a lot about how much, you know, students love that. Later in their career, they always look back and talk about it. So the second thing, the homecoming bonfire, I think that is, you know, very, very unique to Dartmouth. Started over 100 years ago. To be exact, I believe it started in 1888. So it's been a tradition for many, many years. You know, they do a parade for the freshmen and then go to the bonfire where the tradition is the freshmen will run 100 laps around the bonfire. Or, you know, since it's gotten to be a lot of graduating classes now, it's I know they do your class year plus one. In recent years, they've kind of slowed it down because it takes a long time. Some people, I guess, can't run that far. And then they have all sorts of events, sporting events, you know, volleyball game, football game, soccer game, that everybody really likes to go and hang out. And it's all put together to welcome our freshmen into the community. So.
Yeah, I love.
Tim, have you touched the fire as an older alum before these fences have been put up? I know that was a push for some.
I did not touch the fire, but I have seen multiple people touch the fire. and that's going to be one tradition that I kind of miss, but it definitely is more safe for the students now. And picking up on Coach Felino's comments on first year trips, like I love my trip. I was on hike and climb. So we were hiking for half of it and climbing for the other half. Like growing up, I was doing indoor rock climbing, but it was my first experience ever doing outdoor rock climbing. And it was a great way to meet new people because you meet them one day, you get to know each other for a day or two. And then all of a sudden by day three, you're belaying the other climbers that you just met. So it's a really quick way to build trust with other people. And then another thing, when you get to college, a lot of people have anxiety about like, am I gonna make friends? Like, who am I gonna sit with? At dinner the first time you get to college. And the trips is a great way to use. You have your trippies, those people you went on trips with, and it's really great to immediately have like a core group of friends right when you get onto college. And I know a lot of people stay friends with those groups throughout their 4 years and beyond.
Jeff, is that a photo of the bonfire behind you? Is that it?
This is a photo of the bonfire a couple years ago. It's a you know, an aerial pic that I found, and it's great.
Awesome.
You could feel the heat like on all sides of the green. You sweat when you're next to it.
Yeah, you feel like you're melting. So now switching to Coach Wunderlich, are there any traditions you like? I know you were experiencing them both as a student and as a coach as well. What are your favorites throughout the years at Dartmouth?
Yeah, I think, you know, what was mentioned before about the DOC trips and the bonfire are two very specific Dartmouth things that are really cool, like really cool traditions. Each season at Dartmouth, typically there's one really big tradition. Fall is homecoming, winter is winter carnival. And that's something that there's a big snow sculpture in the middle of the green that the students create. There's ice sculptures around campus. There's a lot of events that happen on campus, including like, you know, athletic teams, like indoor sports taking place. One cool thing about the winter too, and a lot of people are afraid of New Hampshire winters. But I can tell you that Dartmouth really embraces the winter culture. One example of that is like the first snowfall, there's a huge snowball fight on the green. All the students come out at midnight, throw snowballs against, you know, and it's just like a really cool community event. There's also the polar bear plunge that takes place during winter carnival. And I know, Timmy, I know you have done that. Me and Coach Dvorsky have done that as well as coaches here. So it's just something that like is specific to just the taking advantage of the area and really embracing the winter up here. And one cool thing that I think our team has traditions too. Like our track team has very specific traditions throughout the year, either with coordinating with the seasons or with just our meets. So like one cool tradition that we have is if you win an Ivy League title, you get your picture framed and put up in the wall in our indoor track office. So we have like a huge collage of photos of all of the history of Dartmouth Ivy League champions. And it's really inspiring to go in there and see like the history of who've come before you and you know, the list of champions, and it's really cool. And that's a tradition that I want to keep going. And I think the students really enjoy as well. And then also like our holiday parties, we do a party with a team during the Christmas season. We do a party with Halloween parties where kids dress up and we come down to practice and work out in our costumes. So those kind of things, just to make it fun and really bring us together and take advantage of the community that we have. I think that is just very special to Dartmouth and something that I think will continue for quite some time. So it's been really fun to be a part of that as a student and now as a coach, for sure.
Yeah, the first snow is always really fun because I grew up in the north where we have snow, but there are a lot of students at Dartmouth, it's their first time ever seeing snow. And then that first day at midnight, you basically see a bunch of kids that have never seen snow before. They're super enthusiastic and it's just like a magical sight to see. And then it's also equally funny because you see a lot of kids from the south or places that don't have snow trying to make snowballs for the first time and try to have a snowball fight and failing a lot of the time. But that's a lot of fun. And then picking up on what Coach Wunderlich was talking about with team traditions, not necessarily that a tradition as far as something that happens every year or every season. But one thing that I think is really special about Dartmouth track is that we sort of have like claimed our own like table, our own section of the dining hall, where every single day, most of the team will go and sit together after practice and have dinner together every single day. So sort of getting the same anxiety of like, when you get to school, you're unsure of like what your friend group's gonna be, you're unsure of like who you're gonna eat with. But when you join the track team, like you can basically guarantee that every single dinner, like you will have like team dinner together. And that's really special. And even meals where it's not dinner, you can always basically count on someone being there to eat your meal with at any single meal. And I think that's really cool as well.
It's a long table, and it's a long table. I don't know how many of you guys are there, but it has to be like 30 sometimes at this table sitting.
Wow. Yeah, and sometimes you'd have to like move it to more than one table too, whenever we're a big team. But we also have coaches that have recently joined Dartmouth staff, so they haven't really been able to experience the Dartmouth traditions themselves, but they've sure heard of them. So Coach Dobson, are there any traditions that you're really looking forward to in your years to come at Dartmouth?
Well, just listening to everybody and of course seeing lots of photos, whether they be online or the athletes have shown me some in the past, or even just listening to Coach Wunderlich, Coach Jaworski, and Coach Farina in the office, just of all their memories and having me crack up a lot about what's going on. But look, I love the stories because it gets me excited, right? I love the experience of just the college life. And that's one thing about Dartmouth, that everyone speaks of the community. And it truly is, because those experiences, they take me back to when I was in college. I laugh like at the winter carnival, because when I was in college, I'd take a cafeteria tray and sled down the hill, you know, whenever it started snowing. I was that type of person. So when I hear about the first snow and the snowballs and all that, it's awesome. You know, I tell the team, I completely bleed green now, right? And if I'm bleeding green, like I want to be in this, you know, I want to participate. I want to be a part of it. So every college has a homecoming, right? But I think what makes Dartmouth's homecoming pretty unique is that it celebrates the freshmen as well. I love that, you know, and I've heard about the bonfire. So pretty funny stories about the bonfire. So I'm looking forward to that. And because we're in the COVID time and in this pandemic, you know, I've been welcomed by the staff and by the administration, but I haven't really had that face-to-face interaction with the team. So I'm really looking forward to, even though I don't directly coach cross country. I'm waiting to get up there, you know, to what is it, the Grant trip, right? Just to kind of go and hang out with the athletes a little bit, laugh a little bit with them, allow them to kind of get to know me a little bit better. I'm definitely looking forward to doing that, taking a couple of days and just spending time with them. So those are just a couple that, you know, I'm really interested in being a part of. And hopefully, you know, down the line, being able to create some new, you know, track and field traditions, you know, as well, with the new folks who are coming in and just welcoming ideas. But these are truly like the fabric of Dartmouth and Dartmouth track and field. So I'm excited.
Yeah, I can actually, one tradition that you're talking about making new traditions, and one tradition that my class did and still continues to do is Secret Santa. So back during winter room, we would have whoever was on campus, we basically have a Secret Santa between the track 7 teams. And we just actually did it again, like via Zoom, like 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. So I think it's like, there's still a lot of opportunities to create your own traditions. So
you guys make your impact. Your class is continuing to do that now?
Yeah, we've done that every year.
That's awesome. I love that. What is it called? I was asking the coaches about this a couple weeks ago. There's so many of them within the team where they pass along like event group traditions or class traditions. What are they called?
Oh, bequests.
Yeah, bequests. Yes. I think those are pretty sweet. Like there's so many of them. I guess we probably not for this conversation, but we could talk about it later, but there's so many. I think that's really cool as well. Yeah.
Yeah. There are a ton of singlets, old singlets, and just old Dartmouth gear and old just like other Dartmouth track and field stuff that has been passed down from generation to generation. So yeah, it's something other students will have to look forward to as well. But our last coach is Coach Wood. Are there any traditions that you're looking forward to experience from what you've heard from us or from other students so far?
Well, I've already strategized what my Halloween costume is going to be. I'll dig out an old Ivan Drago costume. Maybe I can try to, you know, hold a stopwatch and those boxing gloves and you know, self-plan for that. I'll tell you, I'm probably not looking to jump into the freezing cold pond in the middle of the winter, but peer pressure may be able to influence me to do that. But really, you know, I'll say more generally, I'm really excited for the, you know, winning tradition and tradition of excellence at Dartmouth and being part of that and continue to expand and build on that. But right along with Coach Dobbs and just hearing about all these traditions that everybody's enjoyed so much, I can't wait to be a part of them and experience them myself and explore them with the athletes and the rest of the coaching staff and the athletic department. And being a new coach is always, you know, kind of like a little bit different coming in, integrating in, but knowing that all these things are really well established and it opens up a door to understand Dartmouth more and this program more and continue to just integrate into the Big Green community.
Awesome. Yeah, I think the main takeaway here is Dartmouth is a great community. There are great people there and there are so many experiences at Dartmouth that you really can't get anywhere else in the country. Like you can go kayaking on the Connecticut. There are a bunch of huge rope swings. There are places where you can go cliff jumping. There are like huge hikes. There are so many of these awesome things that like you're uniquely positioned to do at Dartmouth that you really couldn't do at any other Ivy or mostly any other school in the country. So I really hope that I'm really looking forward to seeing those traditions continue and see what new ones can come up as well.
Well, very good. We're super excited about moving forward with the traditions, obviously, at Dartmouth. And we're glad that Tim Brennan could join us for the call. Thank you so much for being here with us. And we love welcoming all of our alumni and being able to see you and listen to your great memories about your Dartmouth experience, which just really gets us fired up. And especially Justin, or Coach Wood and myself, like we're super fired up about that. So for all of our listeners and viewers, thank you for listening. Thank you for viewing. This is episode 2, and we look forward to speaking to you again on episode 3 of The Grass is Greener. Woo!